or toothpick up.
My life is full of love and joy and everything I need. I'm in the flow of a bunny dance, and giving is the key. I've got a bunny dance. You've got a bunny dance. I've got a bunny dance. You've got a bunny dance. We've got a bunny dance. I'm rich in spirit, healed and whole. I'm healthy is my creed. I'm in the flow of a bunny dance, and giving is the key.
Here we go.
I've got a bunny dance. You've got a bunny dance. I've got a bunny dance. You've got a bunny dance. We've got a bunny dance. Come on, let's bunny dance. Let's all leap and twirl. Just claim a bunny dance and share it with the world. I've got a bunny dance. You've got a bunny dance. I've got a bunny dance. You've got a bunny dance. We've got a bunny dance again. I've got a bunny dance. You've got a bunny dance. I've got a bunny dance. You've got a bunny dance. We've got a bunny dance.
Going home, guys.
We've got Rick Cowling on the keys.
No. Don't ever say my name when I'm playing keyboards. I don't want anybody to
know. He doesn't think he's a keyboard player. That's hilarious. All right, Rick, take it away. We got another one.
Oh, now it's John's turn.
Turn into their faces. Little darling, it feels like years since it's been here.
Here comes the sun. Here comes the sun.
I say,
it's all right.
Here comes the sun.
Here comes the sun. It's all right.
It's all right.
Yeah, you guys.
Yes. Well, good morning, everyone. The sun is out, and we have some special people in the house. Oh, my goodness, I see Sumerian. We have Reverend Sherri James. Nicole, I haven't seen you in a while either. And we have Rick here. We have Rick home, I said. Didn't I say that? Rick's home. So let's all stand together and sing our fun song, 100 Ways, written by David Roth and Richard Medici. We're finishing our series on prosperity, and this one is something to remember, and it's really fun.
All right. Let me see if I can get the right sound. We're in B flat.
There are at least 100 ways my good is coming to me.
Oh yeah,
there are at least 100 ways my good is coming to me.
Let's do it again.
There are at least 100 ways my good is coming to me. There are at least 100 ways my good is coming to me.
At least 100 ways for me to receive. Sing it out. I embrace my good and I do believe. Here we go.
There are at least 100 ways my good is coming to me.
Oh yeah.
There are at least 100 ways my good is coming to me.
Again.
There are at least 100 ways,
100 ways my good is coming to me. I love this.
There are at least 100 ways my good is coming to me.
Take it, Rex.
There are at least 100 ways.
That's right.
For me to believe.
That's right.
And countless blessings that I now receive. Come on now.
There are at least 100 ways. My good is coming to me.
That's right.
There are at least 100 ways.
How about 1,000?
My good is coming to me.
How about unlimited?
There are at least 100 ways. My good is coming.
Whatever you can conceive, you can achieve.
100 ways. My good is coming to me.
Let's tag it.
My good is coming to me.
Put me in the mind of being on an island. I wanted a Mai Tai. There are at least 100 ways, and the truth is on. Okay, there are at least 100 ways, and the truth is that it's infinite. But you know, we got these human minds, so let's go with 100. Okay. Good morning, everyone. Welcome. I'm so happy to be with you. You are in the right place at the right time for an amazing. Yeah. Spiritual transformation experience. We are going to be open at depth because we want to open up for what the Spirit has for us. It's so wonderful and it's so beautiful and it's so rich and it's so much more than we have ever imagined. I think it is Walt Whitman that says we are so much more than we appear between our head and our feet. That this manifestation, that what you see right now, pales in comparison to what is. There is new music that has yet to be written, new books that have yet to be published, new businesses that have yet to be built. And guess what? God chose y'all to bring it through. So today we are wrapping our 3-week series on abundance and prosperity with an emphasis on the power of forgiveness. You know, forgiveness is one of those things that we talk about and don't always do, but I'm gonna help you. So let's take a moment to say hello to those around us. Smile, say hello to your neighbors, introduce yourself to your friends. Hello, hello everybody. We are on the cruise ship Prosperity, and we are all sailing toward Mount Abundance. And so you just said hello to your shipmates. That's going to be my metaphor for today. You have just said hello to your shipmates, but we are on this thing. We are going to turn this boat around. Those of you that don't want prosperity, we free you to jump off. I love you guys so much. Let's take a moment to just open ourselves. To just open ourselves to the movement of spirit. there is something wonderful that Spirit desires to do in us, through us, as us. That we are the hands and the feet of Spirit. We are here to make life better on earth for ourselves and for all human beings. And so we just open our hearts and our minds and we say, come up through us to us, Spirit. Give us every little thing that we need to know. Reveal to us who we are. Deepen our understanding of what we are capable of. Thank you, Spirit. Thank you, Spirit. Thank you, Spirit. I bless this service. I bless our willingness to transform. And I bless our willingness to be God in action in the world, to be love in our homes, to be joy on the job, to be peace wherever it is that we go. Thank you, Spirit. Thank you that what we get today revitalizes us, opens us in new and exciting and fresh ways. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. This service is blessed. We are blessed. And I pray this prayer in the name and in the consciousness of the mighty I Am presence. That is who we are. And so it is. And amen.
Oh boy, we're going to sing one together. We haven't sung in a long time, but it felt right for today. Spirit am I. So once you have the words, you can close your eyes and take it inside and sing it with me, with all of us. Here we go. Spirit am I. Free of all limits, safe and healed and whole. Spirit am I. Free to forgive and free to change the world. Spirit am I. Everybody sing with me. Spirit am I. Feel it. Free of all limits, safe and healed and whole. Spirit am I. Free to forgive. Free to forgive and free to change the world. Spirit am I. You can close your eyes, I'll give you the words. Spirit am I. Free of all limits, safe and healed and whole. Free of all limits, safe and healed and whole. Spirit am I. Spirit am I. Free to forgive and free to change the world. Free to forgive and free to change the world. Spirit am I. Feel it, claim it with every cell in your being. Spirit am I. Free of all limits, safe and healed and whole. Free of all limits, safe and healed and whole. Yes. Spirit am I, free to forgive and free to change the world. Free to forgive and free to change the world. Spirit am I. Let's just hold that thought as we move into our daily word and our meditation. Spirit am I. Spirit am I.
Good morning. I'm Susan.
one of the members of our Unity of the Oaks prayer team, and Janie will be available to pray with you after service. Now let's prepare for our time of meditation with the reading from the Daily Word. Forgiveness. This is from Wednesday, December 6, coming up. The affirmation, I forgive and find my freedom. Forgiveness is a process of release that starts with willingness. It does not mean I condone the hurt I experienced. It means I am willing to lay down the burden I carry in favor of healing and peace of mind. Forgiveness is a powerful kind of self-care. It need not include an exchange with another because it takes place within. Throughout the process, I prayerfully seek divine direction as I discern what is mine to do. As I forgive others, I also forgive myself for holding on to anger or resentment. Releasing a grudge can compare to flushing out a toxin and restoring well-being. I forgive, and as I do, I open the door to a happier future, to a lightness of being, to a new beginning filled with freedom and possibilities. And according to Psalm 86, 5, for you, O Lord, are good and forgiving, abounding in steadfast love to all who call on you. And again, the word for today, forgiveness, and the affirmation, I forgive and find my freedom.
Let's just imagine ourselves afloat at sea. And it's completely peaceful. We're sitting on the deck, lounging in the chair. There's a slight breeze, but not too cool. The sun is bright, but not too hot. And we're just enjoying this feeling of complete freedom. Free from all worry, free from all care, free from all responsibility. Just free. And in this space of freedom, fresh ideas roll in. Room has been made now to hear the voice of Spirit speak within. Take a deep cleansing breath. Feel the ocean spray on your skin. Thank you, Spirit. Thank you for whatever miracle needed to be worked for us to be in this space. Feeling so free, so easy, like the breeze. Thank you, Spirit. Take a deep cleansing breath. There's no tension, there's no stress, there's no worry. There is just ease. Thank you, Spirit. We allow ourselves to be renewed in this space of freedom. Our hearts are healed. Our souls are restored. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. All is well. As we bring our attention back to this moment, all is well. When you are ready, you may open your eyes. All is well. All is well. All is well. Thank you, Spirit.
Give everybody a second before we jolt them out of this. Maybe we'll start it gently. We need a little of your assistance. We're going to sing, I got the power, you got the power, we got the power, together.
Ready? This is the keyboard.
You got the power, we got the power. Let's build it. I got the power, you got the power, we got the power. I got the power, you got the power, we got the power. I've got the power to make all my dreams come true. I've got the power, there's nothing I can't do. I've got the power to be anything I want. I've got the power inside of me.
Oh, yeah.
I've got the power inside of me. Every day I'm wasting my time thinking that someone else is gonna do it all for me. I've got to get up, get out, get it, just get started. Take one step towards my destiny. I'll define my direction with clear-cut intention. Declare what will be and then watch it come to me. Cause I've got the power to make all my dreams come true. I've got the power, there ain't nothing I can't do. I've got the power to be anything I want. I've got the power inside of me.
Oh yeah.
I've got the power inside of me. There are days when I'm thinking I'm just no good. Days when I don't even want to try. But when I stop, look, and listen, and surrender, I hear the voice of truth I cannot deny. It says, you know you can do it. Just get down to it. Have faith in yourself and the will to see it through. Cause I've got the power to be anything I want. I've got the power to be anything I want. I've got the power to do anything I want. I've got the power inside of me.
Like you.
I've got the power inside of me.
Here we go. I got the power.
I got the power. You got the power. We got the power. Mm.
I got the power, you got the power, we got the power. I got the power, you got the power, we got the power. I got the power, you got the power, we got the power.
Let's say it again, claim it.
I've got the power, you got the power, we got the power.
Amen.
I've got the power, you've got the power, we got the power. I've got the power, you got the power, we got the power.
This is it.
I've got the power, you got the power, we got the power.
I got the power, you got the power, we've got the power. That's it. Y'all, we can pass the plate. That's that's kind of like the whole message right there. Like, I really can't say anything else. I'm going to try this Reverend Ike style. Would y'all indulge me? Anybody know who Reverend Ike is? He gives you a way of communicating that helps you to really feel it. And prosperity is a feeling thing. You feel prosperous before you express. Feeling precedes expression, no matter what. So whatever it is, the feeling comes first, and then the expression follows. You can use your words to drum up feeling. Okay. Let's try this. Hopefully I won't get in my head and I'll just do it. All right. The Lord is my banker.
The Lord is my banker.
My credit is good.
My credit is good.
He maketh me to lie down.
He maketh me to lie down.
In the consciousness of omnipresent abundance. He giveth me the key to his strong box.
He restoreth my faith
in his riches.
He guideth me
in the paths of prosperity.
For his name's sake.
Yea.
Though I
walk
in the very shadow
of death,
I shall fear no evil.
For thou art with me.
Thy silver and thy gold.
They secure me.
Thou preparest a way
in the presence of the collector.
Thou fillest my wallet with plenty.
My measure runneth over.
Surely goodness and plenty
will follow me all the days of my life.
And I shall do business
in the name of the Lord
forever.
Yes.
Thank you guys for playing along. My message today is called Before You Prosper, Forgive. Before you prosper, forgive. And my thesis comes from what we term the Lord's Prayer. Forgive us our debts as we also have forgiven our debtors. This does not mean that Spirit withholds forgiveness. What is being communicated with this verse is a spiritual law that is true everywhere on earth, on Mars, on Venus. I don't care where you go. And the law is, And it's an infallible law of the mind that one idea must be dissolved before another idea can take its place. If you have in your mind any thought that someone has wronged you, you cannot let in the cleansing power of spirit and the richness of spiritual substance until you cast out the wrong thought, the thought of being wronged, and have fully forgiven it. Does that make sense? You may be wondering why you have failed to get spiritual illumination or to find the consciousness of spiritual substance. Perhaps the reason is that there is a lack of room for the true thoughts, because there are other thoughts that are filling your mind. And so if you are not receiving the spiritual understanding that you feel that you should have, you should search your mind carefully for any unforgiving thoughts. Thoughts are things, and they occupy space in the mind realm. They have substance and form, and they may be easily taken as permanent by the one not endowed with spiritual discernment. The reason that I named this sermon "Before You Prosper, Forgive" is because every unforgiving thought is sitting in the way. It is a roadblock. There is construction on the road. You are trying to pass, but there are workmen out there building according to the unforgiving thought, and they are not going to give. In fact, you know what? Sometimes I leave in the morning to get, and I leave with just enough time to be on time and a minute late, and I miss the flow of traffic. And they're building, let me tell you, they are pouring so much money into Glendale, it's amazing. And so on my street in particular, there are all these like luxury high rises that are going up. It's amazing. I mean, who are these people? Glendale was a sleepy town. Like, our anchor store was Montgomery Ward. Like, and now we've got Tiffany's, we got Diane von Furstenberg, we've got Katsuya. Like, it's a lot happening in Glendale. But inevitably, I'm getting out of the house and I'm like, come on, Jordan, it's an assembly line. I got to get you to school, and then I get me to work. And like, come on, let's go. And inevitably, I will get to the end of the block, and there are all the construction workers. And you know they have that sign that either says stop or slow? It never says slow. It is always stop. And I'm just waiting like, all right, come on, let these other cars through so that he can flip the sign and it'll say slow, right? That's what those unforgiving thoughts do. The truth is that prosperity is your birthright. It's what is trying to express through you with desperate abandon. It's trying to. You know this. If you get a paper cut, the moment that the cut finishes being created, the healing is happening, right? The healing is, it's like that with your money. But what happens is that you keep slicing the finger. Okay. Two thoughts cannot occupy the same space at the same time. And so the thought of lack and the thought of plenty cannot exist in the same space. And so you must choose. You can have lack or you can have plenty, but you cannot have both. Is this making sense? Only one gets to stay. The other lies dormant. It doesn't mean that it's not there. This is why you're never stuck. It doesn't mean that it's not there, but it means that it's lying dormant. It's like, you know, if you don't use it, you lose it, right? Okay, y'all catching. So sometimes when I would mess up as a kid, my mom would say, what are you thinking? What were you thinking, right? And that's really what I want to ask you today. What were you thinking? Tell me what kind of thoughts you are holding about yourself and your neighbors or your classmates or your coworkers or your spouse or your family members or that person that you're behind in the line. Oh, my goodness. Let me tell you. I was at physical therapy yesterday because I'm working through some, I'm affirming health. And so I was there, and there's a couple that comes in, and the husband is doesn't have sight, so she's leading him. But let me tell you, she's broadcasting it to everybody. And she comes in and she says, okay, go that way, go that way. And I'm sitting there like, why are you disturbing my physical therapy? My point is that tell me what you are thinking about yourself or that person who walked in and is behaving in a way that you think is uncouth. And I will tell you just what you may expect in the way of health, finances, and harmony in your home. Is that serious? It's like you can't afford these thoughts. Are you suspicious of your neighbors? Okay, not the people that live next to you, but you know the ones that you see on TV that you think these, not y'all, your relatives. I know none of you would hold any of these thoughts. None of you would look at what's happening right now in Congress and go, those people. You cannot love and trust in God if you have hate and distrust in men or people. The two ideas, love and hate, or trust and mistrust, simply cannot be both present in your mind at one time. And when you are entertaining one, you can be sure that the other one is absent. Trust other people and use the power that you accumulate from that act to trust God. Oh, so that's the other thing. It's not like you distrust people, but you trust God. Because our minds, we think of our minds as being able to be compartmentalized, but I'm telling you, it is like putting a red shirt in a white load of laundry. It's all coming out pink. There's no, so harboring a thought of distrust, harboring a thought of ill will, harboring a thought of it serves you right, it's not like it gets cleaned up when you have, like when you're just around the people that you like to be around or when you're in your spiritual life. That thought, it colors everything. Trust other people. Use the power that you accumulate from that trust, from that act to trust God. There is magic in it. It works wonders. Love and trust are dynamic, vital powers. And this is so important because we've got two wars happening, the potential for a third. We've got unrest and discord in our own country, right? And so it can feel like this is a moment when I cannot trust and love, when I must have distaste and disdain. But I'm telling you, students of truth, seekers of truth, people of the light, we cannot afford that kind of thinking. I said last time I was here, we have to be the spice in the soup. We have to be the kick in the in the kicking crabs. Like we have got to be the people that we have. This is gonna be really poor grammar. We have to just be love everywhere. And we have to be the love everywhere we go. Because right now there is so much anger and hurt and sadness. We've got wounds, ancestral wounds, but we're all in this thing together. And so we all have a responsibility to each other. Yes. I'm blanking on the name of the title, but she won a Pulitzer for it. It's a beautiful book where she talks about the waves of migration of people of African descent from the South into the North and into the West. And what is it called? Yeah, Isabel Wilkerson. She's written two books, The Warmth of Other Suns, but I don't know if that's the one. That is it. And it's a beautiful metaphor that she uses. And she says that when you buy the house, you inherit everything that came with the house. And so to say, well, I didn't make the basement leak. Well, you're living here. The basement is leaking. You got to do something about it. Like, that's just how it works. And so we have so much healing, loving work to do. And to say, well, I'm okay over here in my corner, is to pretend like I'm not a part of this collective consciousness. We're all a part of this collective consciousness. And the prosperity of our country, the prosperity of our world turns on people like you and me who say that all people are divine. No?
Yeah.
Okay. Here we go. Are you accusing men of being thieves and fear they're going to take away from you something that is your own? With such a thought, generating fear and even terror in your mind and filling your consciousness with darkness, where is there room for Spirit's light of protection? I can't afford the thought. I can't afford the unforgiving thought. I must do the work to let it go. When I find myself in that space of feeling like someone can take something from me, I don't care who it is, I begin to sing, there are at least 100 ways Spirit can find me. I can be shut off and cut off, and Spirit will find a way, some circuitous route, to get my good to me. My good is always coming to me. I am a magnet for my good. Yes, I move in that vibration. Rather than build walls of love and substance around yourself, send out swift, invisible messengers of love and trust for your protection. They are better guards than policemen or detectives. Let me tell you a funny story. So I was new to New Thought at this point. This is not my therapy session. I was new to New Thought. There was a guy that I was with, and he had this Honda Civic that he loved. And this was really when I learned that protection is not in the devices. And he had just equipped this beautiful Honda Civic with an alarm. And we went outside to leave and go to work, and all that was on the ground were the wires from the alarm. I am not protected by a gun. I'm not telling you not to have your guns. I am not protected by that. I am protected by the words that come out of my mouth. No harm can come to me. No harm shall come from me. My good comes to me with grace, with ease. Everything that is mine finds expression in my life right now. It's possible. We all know these stories of people that survived 9/11. I have a classmate that I went to. A lot of my classmates worked on Wall Street and were in the towers. But one classmate in particular, she said, I just got this idea, and I just started singing and walking down the stairs and was out of the building, and then the buildings come down. Again, it's you can be in complete chaos and begin to tell yourself the truth. When I would go to amusement parks with Jordan when he was younger, of course, you know, you fear like the child getting away from you. And what I would tell him is, this is what you say: Spirit, lead me to the adult that will help me. Because of course there are adults there that have nefarious intent, perhaps, right? But his words create, Spirit, lead me to the adult that will help me. Spirit, you are my protection. And then trust that you are being guided to the right person. My words create my world. And so I cannot, did something come on? Oh no, not Siri. Sorry, Siri, not you. Okay. Siri wanted to make an appearance. This is Fillmore specifically, page 119 in the book Prosperity. Do not judge others as regards their guilt or innocence. Consider yourself and how you stand in the sight of the Spirit for having thoughts about another's guilt. Begin your reform with yourself. Begin to speak, because we have so many things that are happening right now. We're afraid to send our kids into schools, but really, equip your kids to speak the right words. Spirit, guide me right now. Spirit, I put my soul in your hands. Lead me. I choose life. one of the you know, Reverend Della was my mentor, and one of the most powerful things that she shared was being on the Johnny Carson show, which I know y'all don't know nothing about that, but being on the Johnny Carson show, these young people, and she was in the midst of having an aneurysm. She didn't know what was happening, but she felt herself falling, and she said, "Spirit, into your hands I commit my spirit." And then she was out, and she was out for 2 days. And, you know, an aneurysm, this is 1978. This is not like today where, I'm not saying aneurysm is a routine thing, but it's 1978. That's a very different time from a medical standpoint. What she began to do when she came to was to begin to pray, draw to me the things that I need. And it turned out that the doctor who had the device that would help her heal from the aneurysm was in Japan. You don't even know where your good is, but if you will begin to call it, that the circumstances will allow itself, it will seem like it was always going to happen that way, but the circumstances will align itself and draw to you the good that is yours. But again, two thoughts cannot occupy the same space at the same time. So you cannot sit in a spirit of fear and a spirit of love and get the same result. Whatever thought you choose, whatever feeling you choose to be active, is the one that is going to be active in your life. And so we want to practice the law of substitution. We want to invite thoughts that bring plenty, and we want to deny thoughts that invite lack. That's within our power. And so the first thing that we have to do, point number one, is forgive ourselves. None of us escaped. Trust me, when that woman was there, I had been there another day with her. This is how I decided that I didn't want to do appointments at the same time that she was there. She was loud. She wouldn't stop talking. She was harassing her husband, who couldn't see anyway. Like, it was a whole thing. And then she was telling the physical therapist what to do. You know the type. Telling the physical therapist what to do. It's like, you don't have a physical therapy degree, like, or a certificate or anything. Like, let them work with your husband. So it's not like any of us escape from these unforgiving thoughts. And I don't think the idea is not to have the unforgiving thought. The idea is that when I find myself in that space, that I don't let it just sit. That I get involved with my thinking and I begin to affirm, I forgive myself for thinking these ill thoughts to this woman. Because she is doing the best she can with what she has in the way that makes sense to her. And who am I to decide that how she's showing up in the world is not right? I free her and I free you, Sherri, for carrying this thought. And then I immediately begin to bless her and to bless myself. Let the finger of denial, this is Fillmore, let the finger of denial erase every mistake or falling short that you have charged up against yourself. I don't know about you, but I find that I am my harshest critic. When things are not going the way that I think that they should be going or don't look the way that I think that they should look, I find the biggest metaphysical stick. And I am beating myself. How could you? What were you thinking? You know better than this. You're a minister, you know. And the thing is that I can't afford that because I'm the builder of my tomorrow. That would be like hiring a contractor. You want him to build you this luxury estate. You got all the money in the world and you are just laying it out because you are going to live in style. But every day that he shows up to work, you show up with a stick and you beat the crap out of him as he's working. And so he's dodging as he's trying to build your life. What kind of house do you think you're going to have? And yet we do this to ourselves. We are the architects of our tomorrow. And so we really do have to handle ourselves with love and with grace. Forgive yourself. No, you don't want to do the physical therapy appointment with that woman, but bless her. And then forgive yourself for thinking ill thoughts about her. Does that make sense? Yes. Treat mistakes as a mental transgression as opposed to a moral deflection. All I did was I made a mental transgression, but I'm not wrong as a person because I had an ill thought. Deny in thought all tendency to the error way and hold yourself firmly to the Christ ideal, which is your divine self. Point number two, forgive others. Forgive others. Remember, two thoughts cannot occupy the same space at the same time. I don't know, and I haven't done this work because I didn't do any journaling work around it. I don't know what this woman particularly triggers for me, right? But I can forgive her for showing up the way that she did. Coming in, being loud, disrupting everybody else's physical therapy experience, right? I can forgive her. I can release her to show up and do life the way that makes sense for her. Is this making sense? How can we forgive ourselves for holding others in our debt? Shall I be in debt as long as I hold debts against others? This is a question that was put to Fillmore. We find this to be the law of mind. A thought of debt will produce debt. So long as you believe in debt, you will go into debt and accumulate the burdens that follow that thought. Whoever has not forgiven all people their debts is likely to fall into debt himself. I think that, you know, so last time I talked about debt and I talked about the, you know, $33 trillion in debt that we're in as a country, which is quite amazing. And I think that it is important that each one of us do our part to eliminate the debt in our experience. I think that's extremely valuable. But I think that we cannot stop there. That we must begin to spread that consciousness, helping other family members, almost kind of like each one teach one. That if we're going to turn this around, if we're going to get on full footing and begin to walk in our abundance, it really sits on the laps of all of us. I guess what you hear me saying from, and this is maybe where I'm going just theologically in my own life, is that my responsibility is not just to myself. My responsibility is to my world. I'm here to be God on earth. You are here to be God on earth. You are a radiating center of light and love and peace. And our world needs us. Our world needs a group of people who believe in the divine nature of all people. Because that's a rare thing. We take it for granted because we get to hang out on Sundays together, but it's a rare thing. And I think that it is, you know, I don't know if it's inviting more people to church, like invite, just come hang out. I mean, we have a good time. Our music is rocking. Good message. But really taking that responsibility seriously. And I don't mean to make this a heavy thing, whatever, because I did come to have fun today. But I think about that a lot and about who we are and why we're here and why we're still this kind of niche group. What is the only sure way of getting out and staying out of debt? So the first thing is to realize that debt exists in the mind, and the mind is the proper place to begin liquidating any debt. So it is not about discharging debts outwardly, because you'll discharge them outwardly and new ones will come. The thought has to leave the mind. The thought that's supporting it, the thought that put it there in the first place, is what is creating the experience. And so we must begin to forgive ourselves and forgive others. I owe no man or owe no person anything but to love them. The world can never be free from the bondage of financial obligations until people erase from their mind the thoughts of mine and thine that generates debt and interest. He said, this is Fillmore speaking, analyze the thought of debt and you will see that it involves a thought of lack. Dead is a thought of lack with the absence at both ends of the equation. The person spending the money, needing the debt to get the thing, believes that there's not enough, so I have to use this debt instrument in order to get it. And the one who is selling the thing also believes that there is not enough, and I've got to extend this credit in order for them to have the thing. Do you get what I'm saying? So we tend to look at it from the perspective of the debtor, but really the debt grantor is in the same equation. And so it's a mindset that has to shift that says there is enough. I have more than enough to spare and to share. This universe is plentiful. And when I put myself in a space of freedom, the moment that I desire it is also the moment potentially that I'm ready to have it, potentially. But I have to grow into the consciousness of being able to have it, otherwise it'll have me, right? And so the moment that I think it, I begin to affirm it, I am ready to have this. Grow me into the spiritual being that can have this thing, whatever it is, the car, the house, the vacation house, the boat. The things are yours. You know, what does God need a boat for? So, you know, and they keep making more boats. Reverend Della says she thought it was her personal duty to get as many shoes as she could. She's like, God doesn't have any feet. Who do you think these shoes are for? So the stuff is for you. But it is having it in the right order. It is growing into the man or the woman that can have the thing rather than the thing having you. Are y'all following me?
Yes.
And so let's take the 23rd Psalm, Fillmore's version again. You have it in your hands. Did y'all toss it that fast? Okay. All right. The Lord is my banker, my credit is good. He maketh me to lie down in the consciousness of omnipresent abundance. He giveth me the key to his strong box. He restoreth my faith in his riches. He guideth me in the paths of prosperity for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk in the very shadow of death, I shall fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy silver and thy gold, they secure me. Thou preparest a way for me in the presence of the collector. Thou fillest my wallet with plenty. My measure runneth over. Surely goodness and plenty will follow me all the days of my life, and I shall do business in the name of the Lord forever. Yes. So take that, take a sentence, take a verse, take a word, journal with it, work with it 30 days, and just allow yourself to begin to sink. Let this idea that I have more than enough to spare and to share really just sink in. Let it just get in the fabric, in the walls. God bless you.
Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Yeah. All right. One, over in G. Ready to go? One. Yeah, got some inspiration, loud and clear and strong, gave me the motivation. Now there's some changes going on, I'm gonna start a little fire, fit my dreams a little higher, cause that feeling in your gut is never wrong.
No, no, no. We've all got something that we're passionate about. Giving that one thing to the world, won't you figure it out? But you gotta put in the sweat to get what you're gonna get, and turn that whisper into a shout. Girl, we're gonna celebrate all the good things in my life. We're gonna step away from whatever doesn't quite feel right. I ain't gonna love all my whole life long. I'm moving up and moving on. Well, I am grateful for all the blessings that I have. I'm gonna be faithful to all my dreams and plans. I gotta use the gifts I've got and give my all and take a shot. Cause everything I need's here in my hands. Well, I'm gonna celebrate all the good things in my life. I'm gonna step away from whatever doesn't quite feel right. I ain't gonna wait my whole life long. I'm moving up and I'm moving on. All right now. Well, there really ain't no excuse. I've got the drive, I've got the juice. I know
everybody's on my side.
But how can I pass it on if my game ain't coming up strong? I'm ready now to hit my stride. I'm gonna celebrate all the good things in my life. I'm gonna step away from every little thing that don't feel right now. I ain't gonna wait my whole life long.
Moving,
I'm moving up,
moving, moving,
I'm moving up, moving, that's right.
Moving,
I'm moving up,
moving,
and moving on. I'm moving up and moving on, yeah. Moving up and moving on. One, two, three, go. Yeah. There's a lot of words in that song. I'll get them next time for sure.
And I have the love right here for all of you. Hi, I'm Melba, your board member of the day. And here is our mission. If you will please read it with me, it should be up here. Unity of the Oaks is a loving, accepting, and heart-centered spiritual community here to be love in action, to encourage personal growth, awaken spiritual curiosity, and transform lives. We will now be collecting a love offering. Your gift is a way for you to financially partner with us so that we can continue to be a place of spiritual teachings and community in Thousand Oaks and beyond. We will now, I said that. We have several ways for you to give. One, in the seat in front of you are envelopes for cash or check. Include your name if you would like a record of your donation. You'll also find cards with your texting information. Take this moment now to use your phone to give if that is your preferred method. At any time, you can visit our website to give. As our ambassador begins to pass baskets down the rows, if you've given electronically, please still bless the basket with an energy offering, then pass it along. Now join me in taking a moment to focus your attention on your giving heart and feel the abundance of receiving. Visualize the mission statement coming to life. Now please join me in the love offering blessing. Divine love, through me, blesses and multiplies all that I have, all that I give, and all that I receive. I give in love, and I trust God. We are most grateful for all of your contributions to our community as we grow it with lots of events and classes, which is what Betsy is going to tell you about now.
Hi, I'm Betsy Finn. Figure that out. We have so much going on this fall. We're here with a few events coming up. The men's lunch out is next Sunday, October 22nd. That's today. It's this Sunday. Meet Lynn's after the service today, and he'll pick a restaurant, and you'll all walk together. This Tuesday, Women's Heart Talk with Reverend Stacy at 6:30 p.m. This is a safe and supportive space to come together and share and process your experiences and challenges. Save the date for free planned giving workshop by certified financial planner Juan Ross. Get an update on estate tax and laws, and learn about many ways that you can leave a legacy to Unity of the Oaks or other organizations that you love. Halloween next week. Be sure to dress up and join the fun. We'll have a Halloween costume parade for all ages. That'll be fun. All of this can be found along with the links to sign up in the newsletter we send out to your email inbox each week. You can also get more information from our website, unityoftheoaks.org/calendar, as well as on Facebook or Instagram. Our coordinator, Linz, is standing in the back. There he is. You can't miss him. He is here with a laptop after service to help you sign up for the specific events or to answer any questions that you might to sign up for any of our newsletters or that side of sort of thing. And it's now Reverend Sherri James back. Yay!
I love and appreciate you guys so much. I just do. I do. I do. I do. I love you, and there's just pretty much nothing you can do about it. Sorry. I want to say thank you to Tom Hollow for facilitating our organic gardening class yesterday. Thank you. Thank you. I want to say thank you to Janie Fellows for organizing the holiday outing for our community. Well, yes, thank you. Thank you. We have a Janie, prayer chaplain, available to pray with you after service in the room to your immediate left. If you wait outside, they will see you and be with you shortly. We have a prayer box in the back. You can put a prayer in there, or you can email us at during the week at prayerofunityoftheoaks.org. And I want you to know that all the prayers that come into Unity of the Oaks are held in consciousness for 30 days of prayer. Thank you for being here today. You could have been anywhere, but I appreciate you being here. I want you to grab some goodies. We've got some great snacks. I saw some brownies out there, and I was like, nope, just go to the restroom, Sherri. Keep going, keep going, keep going. They look, I know, right? It's 'cause nothing to see here, nothing to see here. Oh, I crack myself up sometimes. Let's stand and do our peace song and take our prayer for protection.
Surrounds us. We are the light. The love of God enfolds us. We are the love. The power of God protects us. We are the power. The presence of God watches over us. We are the presence. Wherever we are, God is, and all is well. Woohoo!